Something that we've realized from all our contest sets is you don't have to be funny to be a comedy quartet. Quartet, you bet. It might be your timing or a passage you wrote, a deadpan choreo. But the four of us decided, and we think you'll agree, that comedy in Barbershop, well, it's not. I said it's not. Even funny.
It's not funny.
But we'll tell you all our secrets if you promise not to share. We've learned a few techniques that you'll soon be made aware. They'll be laughing up a storm when you can finally say,
"Whoa, cut it out!"
Sorry.
This art form that we know and love is just a big cliche.
Bum, 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 bum.
How are we doing, folks? You know, we've noticed that a lot of quartets are doing comedy now at the international level, and we love that. That's great. But we've also noticed that when we take those songs and we do them for a, well, normal audience, they kind of look at us after we finish the song and go, "What?" So, we decided we'd put together a song that would explain, you know, your typical barbershop tropes and things that we do to make something funny. Allow us to demonstrate.
The first thing you need to do is tell a joke. But if you're not funny, use a barbershop trope. Just lift up your arms and nod your head. Then shoot a little wink into the crowd. And when that doesn't work, you can try something more. Say something stupid, just like before. They won't laugh at first, but don't you fret, cause you can slow the tempo down until they get. So you can slow the tempo down until they get. Cause it's the barbershop cliche. Who wants to do real comedy anyway? It sounds kind of hard, so we'd rather not. The silly campy garbage really hits the spot. It's the barbershop cliche. Normal people don't understand, but that's okay. They don't get the humor cause they're actually smart. But their soul's an empty void and they have no heart.
Now these are just a couple of ways to describe barbershop comedy. Now if you don't think there's a bunch of others, you'd be mistaken. In fact, let us teach you one here that is 100% foolproof.
Stereotypes are bad,
so bad,
but in barbershop stereotypes are fine to have. The lead's got a lead,
and the bass is the bass.
It's all the conical structure where the tenor's in space. Whoa, whoa. Yet we scoff and treat them all like a complete disgrace.
And why?
Because it's The Barbershop Cliche. We can't escape it, so what do you say? We can keep trying hard to make high-level craft, or take the easy route and make a barbershop trash. The Barbershop Cliche. We really don't want sixth again. Oh, look at that, we used another technique when we shamelessly asked you for the placement we seek.
Now, the general consensus on recycling is that it's good, right? Well, we like to recycle too. In fact, let us show you a way you can recycle for comedy.
La la la, when people laugh at something that you do, use it again and don't be a fool. Our comedy stylings are second to none, and here's a couple callbacks we've done.
It's the phone with a peel!
Oh, thank you. Good one, Jackson.
Hey, it's Jackson. Dang it!
And then there's plagiarism. You can steal whatever content you want.
We.
But we're better than that, so we'd like to premiere a brand new job that no one's heard that Midtown did last year. That they got from lunch break.
All right, wait, which one are we doing?
The job. Only one, you gotta do it.
The thing?
Wait, no. Why do I have to do it?
You're the baritone.
You're the baritone.
You gotta do it.
Let me catch my breath.
That's good. It's pretty good.
He's not gonna do it. He's been. Here we go. Okay.
It's the barbershop.
We're gonna work on that.
Yeah,
we'll work on that.
It's the barbershop cliche, the senseless, overrated, rubbish junk you hate. So drop your head in your hands and give it a shake. The ones that aren't laughing are the ones with taste. The barbershop cliche. We're out of material, so we must say goodbye for now, but not for long. We really hope you all enjoyed our favorite song.
No, that's not all.
But no, that has to be. We did that's all.
There's more cliches.
But, okay, like, what does it say?
We have to talk to the judges.
No.
What? About
no.
What?
No. Why?
We have to talk to the judges and pretend that we don't like them because we also pretend that they don't like us.
I forgot. Okay. All right. Sorry. Thank you. I'll hold on to that.
Okay.
We'd like to
recognize the judges here to judge our set.
Notice our hands pointing down at the pit. We talk down to you from up on the stage in a cringe-inducing barbershop comedic way, but the audience laughs. You must admit we can get away with it if we commit to the bit. We know it's fake and it makes us sick. We simply have to bribe the judges for a 96.
That's good.
pick it up.
Can you just kick? Yeah, go on.
Well, actually, I'm going to need that back because there's a vending machine down the hall.
No. Come on. We got more. Can you give us a kick line?
Kick line.
Thank you. Yeah.
Bum, 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 bum.
Cause it's the Barbershop Cliche. This song is meta, honest, true, and yes, we mean what we say. We've ignored all the signs, but the proof is all there. And now everybody listening is completely aware.
Please. There's no, we got one more. Patter.
Of the Barbershop.
Come back.
No.
What are you doing?
That was the
we got one more.
Have to sing today, guys.
Right, but we have one more song.